Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. Are you looking to take your Madden game to the next level? Look no further than Civil.gg for the best ebooks on the market. Choose one of two membership options, and don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 25% off. What's going on, guys? Today we have our third update to the wide receiver tier list for Madden 22. Before we hop into it though, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. We are on the road to 30,000 subscribers, so the subscribe button for notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And we are live almost every single night over on Twitch, so if you haven't come through yet, I recommend you do. I will be live tonight over on Twitch for the limited edition reveals, so if you haven't come through yet, like I said, link for the Twitch channel down in the description. And the shout out for today's video goes to my man, Joker Nation. Shout out to Joker for commenting the emoji on last video. So as we always do, let's take a look back at the old tier list, and I made this tier list just over maybe like a week and a month ago, so as you guys can see, the wide receiver landscape has changed quite a bit. I'm going to show you guys the new tier list in a little bit, but keep your eyes on like Roy Williams and like Ja'Marr Chase and see how far they move. Like Ja'Marr Chase is now a C tier. Roy Williams now in C tier. Devin Hester and Calvin did kind of stay up there because they hit thresholds, have still pretty decent speed. Hester actually hits three thresholds, so being a route runner, Devin Hester after the catch, still a really solid receiver, especially because he does get every team chem, so you can really put him anywhere on the field. So I'm a big fan of this Devin Hester card. That's why he's still up so high. We got a lot of the Team Diamond cards, Hoodman Zada, Andre Rison, we got Josh Cribbs, we got Ahmad Rashad. I do think Ahmad Rashad is the worst out of the Team Diamond receivers for sure, in my opinion. Doesn't hit any thresholds, I don't believe. I don't think he does hit any thresholds, which is just not what you're looking for. No thresholds for Ahmad Rashad. And a lot of these cards, if they are, you know, one short of a threshold on their base card, I do factor in that, you know, the card can be powered up and then hit one threshold. So I do factor that in. So kind of keep that in mind while looking at this tier list today. But I'm pretty happy with the foundation for today's tier list. We have Tyler Lockett, Jerry Rice, two really, really good receivers in this game right now. If you're an S tier right now, that is, you're in some very elite conversation. So if you have a theme team with any of these players, I mean, the Seahawks theme team, you got Jerry Rice, you got Tyler Lockett, you got Brandon Marshall. Like the Seahawks theme team, they got some really, really good receivers, and they haven't even gotten a DK Metcalf upgrade yet, which is just absolutely terrifying. So let's hop into it. The first card we're looking at today is going to be the team of the week, Miles Austin. Okay, so 92 overall, Miles Austin. He's got 91 speed, 93 acceleration. Let me fix this real quick, 1 second. And okay, 92 Miles Austin, 91 speed, 93 acceleration. He's a route runner archetype, so one of the fastest route runners in the game. I do feel like we're going to get flooded with route runners over the next couple of weeks, because right now, the route runner archetype is a little bit thin. I mean, we have, Jerry Rice, Miles Austin, I believe. Yeah, Cooper Kupp's one as well, so it is a little bit thin, but I do feel like over the next couple of weeks, you are going to get some pretty glitchy route runners. So definitely be on the lookout for that. You know, that 2AP route tech, that 1AP outside apprentice, all that good stuff. So I'm a big fan of the route runner archetype. Just right now, it is a little bit thin. But Miles Austin, 91, 93, 93 agility. The card is 6'2", 215, so kind of a big body as well. 92 catching, does hit the mid route running threshold, but does miss out on the short and the deep route running threshold. And not many people, if it was like years previous in Madden's where, you know, you had like Go Deep or West Coast chems, it would be a little bit different as far as route running thresholds go. But this year, everyone wants, you know, those plus speeds for those receivers and stuff like that. So a lot of the time, you're not boosting your short route running. Sometimes, and a lot of the times, you are boosting deep route running if you have, you know, deep route specials, whatever it's called, where it adds deep route running and also adds speed as well to your receivers. So that's kind of also a very interesting little factor there. But after the catch, also a really solid card, 92 ball carrier vision. 75 carrying, a little bit concerning, but 93 COD, great after the catch, good spin, good break tackle, good juke move, good size, good archetype. This card, I don't think he's S tier, but I do feel like Miles Austin is, yeah, without a doubt, an A tier receiver. I'm going to put him in front of Chase Claypool and right behind our boy Robert Woods. So next up, we have the 92 overall legend, Andre Johnson, one of my favorite cards in the game right now. 91 speed, 91 acceleration, good catching at 89, 92 catching traffic, does hit two route running thresholds at the mid and the deep route running with a 91 release, 92 spec catch. And yeah, the speed is great. His route running is great. His size at 6'3", 230 pounds. Physical archetype is also great. But my favorite thing about this card is not even his ball carrying. You know, 92 truck, 91 break tackle, 92 juke move with 88 COD, good carrying, Zagi is run block. So 80 run block, even when you're not, and also 82 impact block, by the way, even when you're not passing the ball, if you're running the ball and Andre Johnson's on your football field, he's still making a major impact. That's why I'm a huge fan of this Andre Johnson card. He might not be as fast as Randy or as fast as, you know, Roddy White or a guy like that, but he can do a lot more than Roddy White and any of those other receivers really are able to do, just because he has the run block. He's nasty after the catch. It's two thresholds. Now, 82 strength at receivers, like a tight end out there. This card is just ridiculous. And if you can throw him on, you know, a Titans, Texans, or a Colts team, that's a major W in my opinion. So I'm going to put Andre Johnson up here at S tier, one of my favorite cards in the game in general right now. So next up, we have the 90 overall most feared Brandon Cooks. And I saw a lot of hype around this card. He's definitely a solid option. He does get a ton of theme teams, you know, Texans, Patriots, Rams, and Saints. So a bunch of solid theme teams, 91 speed, 91 acceleration. Unfortunately, him and Calvin Ridley are two really similar receivers. The only real difference is their archetype. So, you know, Calvin Ridley, a route runner archetype. Neither card hits thresholds, but they both have 91 speed. Brandon Cooks, Calvin Ridley, basically the same card, except one's a deep threat, one's a route runner. So for that reason, I'm going to throw Brandon Cooks right behind Calvin Ridley because I do prefer the route runner archetype to the deep threat archetype. So I'm going to go with Calvin Ridley just ahead of Brandon Cooks, but both cards are amazing. And if you want a better deep threat, you want to put, you know, deep in or whatever the case may be on your receiver, then maybe go Brandon Cooks. But if you want a route runner with route tech, then I'd go with Calvin Ridley. So next up, we have the brand new 93 overall team of the week, Roddy White. And I really do feel like this card's going to get overlooked because we kind of just got Brandon Marshall and Randy Moss, and Roddy White only does get one theme team. So, you know, you probably won't see him that much either, but Roddy White is a really, really solid option at receiver right now. 92 speed, 94 acceleration, 88 awareness, 94 jumping. As far as route running goes, he's a physical archetype that hits all three thresholds. So very similar to Brandon Marshall. 92 catching, 92 catching traffic, good release, good spec catch. As far as being a ball carrier goes, 93 carrying with a good stiff arm. The spin, not the greatest, but 87 COD with an 86 juke and an 85 break tackle with a 67 run block. So Roddy White, I do feel like this card is a really underrated card. I honestly might be underrating him myself. But yeah, I'm going to throw Roddy White right behind Andre Johnson, a 6'2 physical archetype. Sorry, a 6'. 6' physical archetype, three route running thresholds, solid after the catch, great speed, great acceleration. Roddy White is a no-brainer S tier. So next up, we have the 93 overall player of the week, Cooper Kupp. And I'm not going to lie, this card was done dirty. I mean, he still has good stats, and I think he's still, you know, in the top two tiers as a receiver in this game right now. But this card could have been so much more if they gave him like maybe 92 speed, for example. Like I just kind of went over with Miles Austin. The route runner archetype is very thin right now. And Cooper Kupp doesn't really help that out too much, because if we go down to his price, he's still going for about, you know, almost 300K, which I don't think this card is worth right now. But 92 speed, 92 acceleration, does hit three thresholds, which is definitely a W. But at 90 speed, if you're not going to put him on a theme team, I don't see a point in going to get this card, honestly. I really don't. I'd rather see with like a guy like Jerry Rice, for example. But if they gave Cooper Kupp like 92 speed, this card easily would have been a top five receiver. But because of the speed, I mean, he saw it after the catch with, you know, good COD. I wish his spin and juke were a little bit higher. But I like how he hits three thresholds. I like his archetype. He's 6'2", 208. So kind of a big body receiver as well, which is kind of slept on when it comes to Cooper Kupp. But, I mean, they definitely cheated Cooper Kupp speed for sure. I'm going to throw Cooper Kupp. I mean, he's still a good card. I think he's still probably top 10, right? But, yeah, he could have been so much more. I'm going to throw him right in front of Robert Woods. And him and Robert Woods are basically the same card. Like, these two cards are so similar. Three thresholds. I'm pretty sure they're both route runners as well. But, yeah, Rams theme team, you basically have two of the same exact receiver, which I guess does make sense. But Cooper Kupp, solid card. Again, I feel like they just cheated his speed. So next up, we have Marquise Colston, another really overlooked card, you know, because Team Diamonds, they came out and everyone, you know, has a Raiders theme team, got Hushman Zahner and, you know, Andre Rison or Josh Cribbs. So yeah, Marquise Colston, not even the fastest Team Diamond receiver, but I do think he is the most versatile out of the bunch of those Team Diamonds. This card reminds me a lot of like a baby version of that legend Andre Johnson. 89 speed, 89 acceleration, great strength, good jumping. Card is 6'4", 225, and as route running goes, he's going to hit the short and the deep route running threshold. Good spec catch, good catching. Like I said, good size, good archetype. After the catch, he could be a little bit better, I'm not going to lie. But 77 run block with 78 impact block. A really good run blocker. Good size, good strength, good speed. Two route running thresholds. A really, really solid card that you really haven't seen a lot of, because the Saints theme team is not a popular one. But If you have a Saints theme team, you know how dangerous this card is. So Marquise Colston, we're going to throw him right in front of Andre Rison. You could debate him maybe over TJ, but I've seen TJ do some very nice things in game. Maybe because I only see him on Raiders teams. But that's why I like TJ a whole bunch, and also the hair, you know, all that stuff kind of just play a factor. But I'm going to put Marquise Colston. I mean, you could debate him in front of Marquise Brown, who's got 92 speed, no route, any thresholds. But I'm going to leave Marquise behind him and keep him in front of Andre Rison for sure. So next up, we have the fastest wide receiver in the game right now, and that is the 93 overall, 93 speed, 93 acceleration, Will Fuller. You might not see a lot of this card because, you know, Will Fuller's price tag is a little bit hefty. It's actually a pretty good price right there, 800K ain't too shabby. But yeah, the fastest wide out in the game right now, 93-93, and does hit two route running thresholds, which is interesting because, you know, I'll get into some receivers later that don't hit two thresholds that are also really good. But Will Fuller hitting two thresholds, being the fastest wide out in the game, good catching, good release, good carrying. This card is the real deal, I'm telling you right now. Might have some holes as far as, you know, strength maybe, or a run block maybe, or, you know, after the catch might not be the greatest. But that speed and that release and that route running is no joke. So for that reason, I'm going to throw our boy Will Fuller. Right now, I think on this tier list, he is the best receiver that we've seen so far. He has the speed, two thresholds. This one's kind of a no-brainer. Will Fuller, I think he's easily an S-tier receiver. So next up, we have the super glitchy 91 overall flashback AJ Green with 91 speed, 90 acceleration, 89 catching, 88 catching traffic, 88 short, 89 mid with 92 deep route running, 91 spec catching, and 90 release. After the catch, he's pretty solid with a 90 juke move, 86 carrying, and an 85 COD. And as far as run blocking goes, he's not the greatest. But AJ Green, the card is 6'4", physical archetype, great speed, great acceleration. When powered up, he will hit two thresholds, which is definitely a major plus right there. So AJ Green, in my opinion, I think that I really do believe that AJ Green is a better receiver than both Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods. Honestly, these wildcard Wednesday drops, I mean, obviously besides heavyweights, I mean, there have been some pretty good offensive linemen that we've got from heavyweights, but I mean, Wildcard Wednesdays have given us some really, really good cards. I mean, you see Claypool here. You see DeSean Jackson as well, who came out the same exact day as AJ Green. But I'm going to throw AJ Green in front of Cooper Kupp. I just love his speed, his size, his archetype, his route running. This one's kind of a no-brainer for me. I mean, you could debate him. You might be able to debate Kupp and Woods over AJ Green. But in my opinion, I'm putting AJ Green before both those guys. Okay, so next up, we have the 90 overall team diamond, Charlie Joyner. And I think this card right now by far is the best team diamond receiver in the game right now. 91 speed, which is the fastest. Also does hit two route running thresholds. Good spec catch. Great after the catch with 91 COD, 90 juke move, 91 spin, 91 ball carrier vision. So a really, really nice receiver. Wears the one, you know, the one face mask strap. Does get, I believe he does get Bengals. What team does he get? He does get Bengals, Chargers, and Titans. So Titans theme team, who they got right now? They got Andre, they got Randy, and they got Joyner right now as their top three. That's a really scary top three right there. But Charlie Joyner, a really, really nice card. 91 speed, two thresholds. It's hard to beat that. So I'm going to throw our man Charlie Joyner up here at A tier before AJ Green. I do think he is the best A tier receiver. Honestly, a fringe S tier player as well. Charlie Joyner is a really solid option at receiver right now. And we are down to our final two cards. And right here we have the limited time 94 overall Brandon Marshall with 92 speed, 92 acceleration, 80 strength. And where this card really does set itself apart is the route running. 92 short, 94 mid with 95 base deep route running. Good release, good spec catch, great catching. After the catch, this card's also an absolute menace. With 94 break tackle, 94 juke, 88 COD, 90 truck, 84 carrying, and also can run block a little bit as well. And not to mention, he's also 6'5 and weighs 232 pounds, physical archetype. So Brandon Marshall, I mean, you guys see the route running, you guys see the size, the speed, the animations that this card gets are just absolutely ridiculous. So this one for me is a little bit of an easy one. I'm throwing Brandon Marshall right to the top here. This card is just, he's just a problem, can do everything, break tackles, run block, run, can run every single route in the game, good in the red zone, good over the top, good speed, good size. This card doesn't make sense to be this good. It really doesn't at this point of the year. We shouldn't be seeing a card with 95 deep route running. It really does not make sense how good Brandon Marshall actually is. And finally, last but not least, we have the 93 overall Randy Moss. And I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you guys, this Randy Moss is one of the worst Randy Mosses that we've seen. And it's kind of crazy because the worst Randy Moss that we've seen is better than a lot of receivers in this game right now, which is terrifying because this card could have been so much more. Like, it doesn't even make sense
like why this card has some of the stats that he has. It doesn't make sense that Randy Moss only hits one route running threshold when he's powered up. That does not make any sense to me when you have guys like Will Fuller or even Brandon Marshall. Like Brandon Marshall, what does he have? 95 deep route running. You're trying to tell me right now that you're going to give Brandon Marshall 3 better deep route running than Randy Moss and then not let Randy Moss hit any other threshold? So Randy Moss, he's still a really good card, don't get me wrong. I mean, he's still 6'4", still gets great animations, still has great speed, great acceleration. They've been a little bit better after the catch this year with a 90 COD and stuff like that. But this Randy Moss card could have been so much more, and it's kind of weird doing this because usually, you know, whenever we get a new Randy Moss card, he always just goes here. But I think Randy Moss is behind Will Fuller here, and honestly, I don't think you can debate these two. I think these two are definitely the top two in the game right now. But honestly, like any of these five right here, they can all be swapped around in my opinion. I really do feel that way. So if you are watching and you have any disagreements, drop your comment down below. I do read every single comment. But yeah, I could see a lot of debates for maybe even Andre Johnson being jumped or by Roddy White. Like I could see a lot of debates. My top five though today, Brandon Marshall, Will Fuller, Randy Moss, Andre Johnson, and Roddy White in that top five. But I'm pretty happy with how the tier list turned out, and we added a bunch of new receivers today. As you guys can see, there's all the red core elites, and now we have a lot more color, a lot more variety out here, which you'll love to see. So yeah, if you are still watching, let's comment the hamburger emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And as always, I'll see you boys in the next one.